Hi, my name is Beth Hiley here for Board Game Geek at Spiel 2019. I'm sitting now with Blaże Kubacki from Board and Dice, and you've brought us Trismegistus, which I will totally admit, I was holding the box here to help me out with the name. You guys said you're calling it Tris for short.
We're calling Tris for short. It's also called the Ultimate Formula, so you can always use that to find the game.
The Game of Magical Alchemy.
The Game of Magical Alchemy. So, what you are going to be doing in this game, you're going to be drafting and using dice. And one of the most important things in the game is that everything matters about the dice. Their color, their symbol, and which bowl then they ended up in. So what you do during a round, you're going to be, if you don't have a die on your player board, can we make the player board come into view a little bit?
Which, by the way, is a double-layered player board.
It is. So, when you take a die, like this one, you look at the number of dice that are here in this bowl, and this is the level, the potency the die is going to have. So we're going, this was five dice, we're going to put it on five, which means that you basically will be able to do five actions with it. Mm. Although it has a few little hitches, because some of the actions will simply take one potency, some of them can take more if you want to gather resources, for example, and this is one of the actions. Those little cute cubes come from gathering resources. So then you look at the symbol, for example, and the symbol is this one. You go down one, two, three during an action, for example, and you put three cubes in there, thus gathering resources. Now, why is the color important? Because you can transmute resources. You can transmute resources down black arrows. So, for example, if I wanted to use one of this potency, I could transmute this resource into this going through here. Hmm. Now, you can see the little indentations here. What are those? Well, this is one of the coolest part of the game. These are artifacts. You can purchase one during the game, you can purchase more than one, obviously. And when you do it, every time you transmute through this line, you can use the artifact for its special ability. When you transmute, because that's not everything, when you transmute, I'm going to move that away.
Thank you.
You're going to be spending resources. One of four resources depicted here. And whenever you do, you're going to be going up those tracks. What we don't have here, we don't have the bonus tokens, but there are bonus tokens here every time you go far enough, basically, to reach one of those bonuses, you receive that bonus. But also, this is important for another action you are going to be performing. Now, when you have a die, and let's come back to this die again. It is a die with this symbol. So, with this die as an action, I can take one of those experiments. I take them in my hand, and whenever it is my turn, if I have everything depicted here, I can perform this experiment. Let's take a look at this experiment. This experiment requires a certain number of resources. These have to be transmuted resources, so you first have to move them up. Now, it also tells you that you need to be on a certain level of a mastery track. And this is this track. So whenever you transmute, you're going to be moving up those tracks. And one of the very important reasons is that you want to move far enough to be able to perform experiments. Now, when you do that, the experiment will immediately give you some stuff for you. Like, for example, this one allows you to move even further up that
mastery
track.
Right?
It will give you an ethereal die. An ethereal die is a cool little thing which you can use whenever you take a die from here to add potency, and it'll score you points at the end of the game. This is, however, not everything you can do to score points at the end of the game, because at the end of the game, you will also have publications. A publication is a card that can score you massive points, but firstly, you will have to have whatever it scores you for. And secondly, you'll have to have a bunch of symbols to firstly activate them. And where you take the symbols from? Well, you take them from artifacts and you take them from the board, the mastery board. Now, let's come back here again for a moment. As you can see, there is in the middle this grid. This is the Philosopher's Stone. Whenever you perform an experiment, depending on its color, so for example, when it's red, it comes in here. These, actually, usually they are face up, and when that
which are
happens,
wooden cubes, by the way, which is a nice touch. That
they're tiles reminiscent of Teotihuacan ones.
Yes.
They're just a little smaller. And when you put the first experiment in, you're allowed to take one of these and put it wherever you want in the alchemical grid. Now, when it goes into the Philosopher's Stone, you can at any time flip it to receive whatever is an advantage on the tile. And if you at any point put two of them in a row or fill up a column, you immediately receive everything on the both ends of this row and column. We have five player boards. Each of them is different when it comes to this. So every one of them has a different set of cool things.
Right, so just like to hold this side by side, you can see like that top row, your bonuses would be different.
Exactly. Now, you can see those little lightnings here. They are also really important because as your opponent makes a turn, and a turn is simply, if you don't have a die, you draft it. If you have a die, you will simply move it down to perform one of the actions I was talking about. And when it's your opponent's turn, you also, during the game, get these little things, which are reaction tokens. You always start with three. They replenish at the end of the round, and every time it's somebody else's turn, and they say, okay, I'm going to use my... let's say it was this. I'm going to use my die here. I'm going to go down once, and let's say I'm going to get one of these resources. Now, you can say, okay, I want to react to that. You flip the tile over, and you can do whatever you want with the potency of one. So again, you can use the color, or you can use the symbol of the die to perform an action, to maybe do a transmutation of your own. Or maybe you want to get a new resource, or maybe you want to get a new ethereal essence. This essence allows you, alchemical essence, this essence is the currency you pay for going up the tracks whenever you transmute. So everything is tied together.
Yeah, I can see it could be very puzzly. Sorry, if I can do this, and it lets me do this, lets me do this.
It is. However, a very important thing, you always do that single action when your turn comes around. So basically you do one thing, and then it passes to the next player, and then you can react.
Really moving.
Exactly, but you can react, and then it comes back to you, and then you perform yet again a single action, and in the end, there isn't a lot of downtime in the game because of this structure. Still, this is a meaty, deep game, I think.
Probably north of 2 hours, I imagine, as well.
It really depends, because the first time you play it, yeah, probably, but later on, two-player games are basically an hour tops. And with a full complement, I don't think it will go far north of 2 hours.
All right. Hey, not bad. Well, if you guys want to check that out, this is from Board and Dice, which is Trismegistus. The ultimate alchemy, the ultimate formula, which is about alchemy. And Vijay, thank you so much for letting us take a quick look. A very quick look for a very big game.